track behind me is in an NRL stadium. It's a Wind Stadium, and it's home to the NRL team, St George Dragons. It's a bit overcast here at Woollongong. Hopefully the rain holds off, and it's not a wet race like last week. The boys from Hart Huntington are out there at the moment, just walking the track and checking out some lines.
You know, for this round we're running pink grips. You know, all the riders are doing something pink, pink graphics, pink grips, pink plastic. You know, it's breast cancer awareness, and you know, everyone's pitching in and, you know, putting on pink stuff, so it should be good.
Yeah, man, he loves it. He's back in racing. He always loved racing. He won't much to do a freestyle, but he's over it. As soon as he heard a bit of a word that I'm racing again, he's back in it, smiles on his face, loves it. Yeah, that's it. Jokes around and everyone has a laugh with him, and that's about it, man. So I smoke a
little bear, drink a little. Welcome?
Yeah.
I figured I might as well try to be Aussie from here. Kale hooked it up. I'll be fine, I get by.
I barely get by. See how he goes, qualified third, only 0.1 of a second off the leader, so now he's in for a real good chance. Let's see what happens. Just a sun shower, mate.
Oh, same as last weekend, it looks like. Let's see what happens, hopefully it doesn't rain. I barely get by.
I barely get by.
Again today in the Hart Huntington pits, we've rocked it out as normal. DJ was spinning tunes again. The good head beers were flowing. Just unfortunate that Tango and Luke didn't make the main events, but hopefully Blose can come away with the win.
Honestly, I thought I might make it. I've got a good gate pick. Got the whole shot, but then Chris Blose won it, and Bordy got past me, and then that's it. I couldn't catch him after that. But I'm happy I got the whole shot, first one.
Yet again, looks like the weather's going to be pretty bad conditions. You know, it's actually starting to come down pretty hard now. It's been dry all day, but unfortunately, we'll see what we can do in the wet.
Try and minimise places where mud can actually go and make the bike heavier. So all in between this guard and the motor is filled with foam all the way back to there. So that can't fill up with mud and make it more heavy. Bit of foam in here stops mud building up so you can't change gears. Silicon spray under all the mud guards and everywhere we can, because the mud has trouble sticking to the silicon spray. Bit of tape over some of the airbox holes so water can't get in and the motor can't suck water. The rest is up to him.
Yeah, I had to go to LCQ. I won my LCQ and, you know, went to the main event. You know, right before that it just started pouring down rain. I crashed on the start, first turn, and worked my way back to like fourth or fifth or something like that. I was really charging, doing really good, and everything kind of started going downhill from there, and I'm just kind of waiting for a dry round to come and show what I can do.
Lightning, thunder, hail, everything else. So it's shit, you know what I mean? Like, I don't know how they can race in these conditions.
Yeah, thunder, lightning, rain, wind. I think we had it all tonight, as you can see. Yeah, you know, we had some bike setup issues and after practice that we got carried away. My bike worked a lot better. You know, I qualified third fastest. I think I was like 1/10 off of Jay Marmont. And, you know, it felt like my speed was there. I could have won tonight, but it's not what the end result is. And hopefully we can get that next round.